Hey guys, in this video, I'd like to discuss how vitamin K and warfarin works and what is the relationship between them and why we give, like, you know, when you have vitamin K overdose, warfarin, why you give warfarin when there is a vitamin K overdose, right? So, how exactly vitamin K works is, it involves in the formation of the clotting factor. So, where exactly clotting factor formation will occur? It is happening in the liver. Right, so we have factor number 2, 7, 9, and 10. So these factors, the factors 2, 7, 9, 10, they require, for example, let's take they're in the form of precursors. Right, so these precursors of factor number 2, 7, 9, 10 has to be formed in the such a way that they are ready for the clotting formation, right? So these precursors should be formed into inactive factors. So how exactly vitamin K involves is, these factors require vitamin K as a coenzyme, which means it is like a catalyst for the formation of these precursors to the active products, whatever is required. So, vitamin K in the reduced form, vitamin K in the form of reduced. So, this reduced vitamin K is the one which involves in the formation of these factors, right? So, this reduced vitamin K forms vitamin K epoxide. After this reaction happens, so reduced vitamin K involved in this reaction and we got the factor 2, 7, 9, 10. Right, from precursor state. So this vitamin, whatever is involved, is further converted into vitamin K epoxide. Right, so this vitamin K epoxide, whatever is formed, it should come back to reduced form of vitamin so that it will involve in this reaction once again. Right, so this should convert back into reduced vitamin K. So, who will do that reaction? That is done by vitamin K epoxidase. So, that enzyme name is vitamin K epoxidase. Right. So, this is how vitamin K works in the formation of the clotting factors. So, we know how exactly it involved and what exactly warfarin does. Warfarin will come and inhibit this enzyme. Warfarin, what it will do? It will inhibit this enzyme. So, by this, we will understand one thing. Vitamin K is the one which involves in the formation of the clot or coagulation, while as warfarin is an anticoagulant. Right. So, now by the mechanism, we know that it is an indirect anticoagulant. And where exactly we use warfarin? Right. Now let's discuss some uses of warfarin. So that includes warfarin uses, that includes, we have, for example, we have DVT, that is deep vein thrombosis. So what exactly happens in deep vein thrombosis? In the veins, which deep veins of the leg, there is a formation of the clot. So to prevent that, we use warfarin. So we use it in a prophylaxis of the deep vein thrombosis. We use it in pulmonary embolism prophylaxis. So, what exactly prophylaxis? To prevent the pulmonary embolism. Let's take a patient now who is having cardiac surgery and his valves has been replaced. So, he is having an artificial valve. And whenever we have an artificial valve, there is a tendency for the clot formation. So, to prevent that, we use warfarin. So, in the prosthetic valves. Right, so these are the few important, and we can use it in the prevention of strokes. Right, so these are the uses of warfarin. Now let's talk about when we can use vitamin K. Vitamin K, whenever we have overdose or poisoning with warfarin. Right, where exactly we can use? In the child, in the neonates, immediately after the birth, they have a tendency to develop hemorrhagic diseases in the newborn. So to prevent hemorrhagic diseases of the newborn, we use vitamin K. So to prevent hemorrhagic disease of newborn. Right. So this is another use. We also can use in the treatment of some bleedings. But one thing we should remember, when we are treating for the patients who is having bleeding, vitamin K will start to act, not immediately, as soon as we give the injection it doesn't act, but it will start to act very slowly, that at least it will take 18 to 24 hours to show its function. So this is a key point which we should remember if we are using it for the patients who is having bleeding, right? So now, so this warfarin is derived from a substance called cumarin. Warfarin is derived from a substance called cumarin, right? So there are other drugs, there are other derivatives of cumarin such as neoducumarin, but one of the most commonly used drug is warfarin. So what are the side effects by using warfarin? Let's see now. So whenever we are using warfarin, the patient can develop tendencies to bleed. So the patient will complain episodes of bleeding, right? Warfarin also causes a syndrome called purple toe syndrome. And one more thing about warfarin is contraindicated in pregnancy. If at all we use warfarin in pregnancy, it can lead to a syndrome called fetal warfarin syndrome. It called as fetal warfarin syndrome. In this syndrome, what happens? The baby will have a skeletal abnormalities. So this is a story of our vitamin K and warfarin. Thank you guys, keep following.